Hey, this is Jeremy at Frank Otte's Nursery. Today we're in this gentleman's backyard. We're going to plant a 15-gallon tree. The first step to doing so is we're going to make a 4-foot side ring. We're taking a 4-foot circle aside so we have a nice spot to do the tree. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 2 steps from the flag, mark it. Now that I have all this marked, I'll make my circle. Now that we've got our sod ring made, it'll make it a lot easier when the gentleman cuts his grass. He can just go right around the tree. And we're only planting a 15-gallon tree, so it's not that big. A lot of people say dig your hole twice as wide, but we have a trick to doing that without physically removing the dirt out of the hole. So we'll get our hole dug and then we'll show you how to do the rest. All right, now that we've got our hole dug, this is roughly what you want your hole to look like for a 15-gallon tree. Now we're gonna add in some planting materials. Here I have a mixture of a peat moss, pine bark mulch, and some mushroom compost. And we're also gonna throw in some holly tone, or is that biotone? I think it's biotone. It's a good root stimulator. It's got mycorrhizae in it. You want to mix all this up real nice. Fluff that soil up. And then we'll place the tree in to make sure we've got our depth right. And we'll raise it up a little more. We'll add more. We don't want our tree too deep because you can drown a tree. Now that we've got the right depth, we want to make sure we have the good side facing towards the street, the wide side. And I believe that is the side. Now, being a 15-gallon tree, it's pretty rooted in. We're going to score these roots all the way around the tree. You won't hurt the tree by doing this. A lot of people get scared, but you're not going to hurt it. And then, remember earlier I was saying, most people say dig your holes twice as wide. Instead of doing that, we cave in the sides. So we're achieving this without physically removing the dirt out of the hole, making more work for yourself. Now that we've got this tree in the ground, we've got all the dirt caved in around the edges, we're going to add water. It's something we like to call puddling it in. It helps to pack this dirt down and settle it, and it gives the tree a good last deep watering. Once we get the water turned on, we'll get it watered. There we go. And as Andy's watering it in, I'm going to kind of go around with my shovel to pack all this dirt in around this tree. It'll help keep it from settling over time, and it'll give it a good deep watering. And now we'll continue to add more dirt till we get to the level that we want to achieve. And now that we've got our dirt firmed in, we've got the tree at the depth we want, we're gonna put 2 things on top. This is called Easy Weeder. It helps to keep weed seeds from germinating and sprouting. And the mulch that we'll put down will help with that as well. And then I'm gonna add a product called Holly Tone. It's a granular fertilizer. Put that on here, it's all organic. You wanna be pretty generous with this stuff. And now we'll get our mulch and mulch the tree.
Raindrops are falling on my head, And just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit. Those raindrops are falling on